Don't take your jacket off. You're not staying.
Fine, I'll make it fast. Chris Stamp will be released from the hospital any day now, and he's going to need some help.
I know.
Well, the guy has this retro macho thing going on, and he'd rather have a root canal than ask for help, but he's going to need it.
What's it got to do with you, honey?
We've done a little bonding.
You and Chris?
I'm good for him, Myrtle. I've got him to open up. I got him to lighten up.
Are you trying to tell me you did this out of the goodness of your heart?
I'm close with his son, Ryan. I don't know if you know this,
but... Yeah, Chris is Ryan's father. I did hear.
Anyway, the plan is I'll be kind of undercover. And I'll be watching out for Chris, but he won't know he's getting help he didn't ask for.
You are going to help him with his rehab?
Well, he'll have hospital types with degrees for that, but they'll need someone for other stuff. You know, run errands, that sort of thing. And I do make him laugh. So, what do you think?
I think it's rubbish.
I know what you think of me, and I know you have your reasons.
And you think I should ignore my reasons?
This would be good for Chris and me. You'd be giving me a shot at doing something good, Myrtle. Couldn't you do that?
I know I've got the reputation for giving people a second chance.
That's why I'm here.
I try to be fair, but I am not a fool. Now you close that door on your way out.
Damn it. Kendall! Bianca, I didn't know you were here.
It's a good idea, you taking care of Chris.
Myrtle doesn't agree with you.
Myrtle and probably everybody else. People don't trust you.
But you do?
I think that you would be good for Chris. He's tough, and you give as good as you get.
Do you really think that?
Why, do I have some reason to suck up to you?
Myrtle basically turned me down just now.
Yeah, I heard.
What would I owe you? I mean, what would it take for you to... Would you help me convince her to give me my own room here?
I don't buy it. Helping Chris is not going to help you win any points with Ryan. And if you know him, you know that.
Okay. I had a moment of truth. I suddenly realized I had to go forth and do good. There might have been a little white light involved.
Kendall, don't believe your own press. You're just like everybody else. You want people to approve of you and to accept you.
Is that what you want?
All my life.
What was it like being in love with someone that you knew Erica would freak out about? You and Frankie must have had a really special relationship. Oh, was that the wrong thing to say?
No. It's just, even when I find somebody who's willing to talk about me and Frankie as a couple, usually they get a little weird because she died.
Well, I'm not real sensitive. So what was she like? I mean, her sister seems real tough. Was Frankie?
Yeah, Frankie was. And she wasn't. I mean, on the outside, she was all attitude. But inside...
Mush.
Right. She was really gentle. And really, really vulnerable. I mean, I never met anybody who needed to be taken care of as much as Frankie.
Well, she came to the right place.
Me?
Don't you believe your own press either.
I don't. I'm just surprised that somebody gets that I'm not poor, helpless, fragile Bianca. was trying to get her to feel safe so that she'd open up to me. I wanted to see if she could. I wanted that a lot.
I'm sorry you never got that.
Thanks.
Are you still here? Is she bothering you?
No, she's not, Myrtle. Do you mind? Can I talk to you in private for a minute? You don't mind hanging out, right? We'll just be a second.
Okay. I forgot to lock up the silver.
I wonder if it'll work. I have already told Chris that I'm the one who hired Dr. Stannard for him. Just in case you were thinking of stabbing me in the back. Whatever.
Bianca, hi. Hi.
Hey, Myrtle. And I talked it over. She says that if it's okay with me, it's okay with her.
Thank you. What, honey? What? What's going on?
Kendall is moving in here. My sister and I are going to live together.
No, Bianca, you can't live with her.
All I want is a place to stay. I'm not going to steal her soul.
Bianca, you don't understand what she's trying to do. She's trying to make you hate me.
Now I figure you can manage that all by yourself.
You see, she's trying to come between us, honey.
Oh, Mom, please.
She's just using you, Bianca, to get to me. Because she knows that that is the one way she can hurt me.
Mom, get out of our house. Now.
I love you, honey. And I just hope that we can talk about this some other time.
I'm sorry about that, Bianca. I never would have asked to move in here if I'd known she was going to go off. Shut it, Kendall. That was exactly what you were hoping would happen.
Okay, I'm not gonna lie. I knew it would drive Erica out of her tiny mind if she knew I'd moved in here. I'm everything my mother says I am.
Well, it doesn't matter what you are, Kendall. She still had no right to come in here and just start
throwing her weight around. She may not have much to throw, but it sure does pack a wallop, doesn't it?
I hate it when she gets to me.
Bianca, what happened just now wasn't your fault.
I don't want to be mean to her.
I can see that.
It's just, she comes in here and she just heads right into drill sergeant mode. And I lose it.
Bianca, she's a... Never mind.
What were you going to say?
No, I'm going to do you a favor, and I'm just going to keep my mouth shut, because right now you don't need me trashing Erica.
I don't know what I need.
You care about her. I can't relate, but I can recognize it. And even though she makes you totally crazy, you still don't want to be mad at her. So I'm not going to make it worse.
Kendall, that's... absolutely nice of you.
Yeah, well, don't let it get around. I don't want to mess up my reputation.
Bianca Montgomery, right?
Yeah.
Lewis Hall's from The Exposer.
Oh,
Bianca,
no,
how did you
here.
Feel when you found out they got Proteus?
No.
Was it a shock when you heard that
I'm
Proteus killed
your
girlfriend?
I'm not going to answer your questions,
look,
okay? So just
one
go.
Word, look.
Just go.
What was the first word?
Why, Binks. Who's the hottie? Aren't you going to introduce me?
Are you talking about me?
Mm-hmm.
I'm Lewis.
How did you do that?
Practice. I've had some really bad dates in my time.
I owe you.
I owe you. For the room.
But Kendall, I know you like to joke about your reputation and...
Bianca, you don't
have to. No, I just want to say, I think you get a bad rap.
How did you come up with that?
I've got this test.
And I passed? That's a first.
When you asked me about Frankie before, you were really interested. You weren't just saying the words. I've gotten to know the difference.
I bet you have.
You cared what happened between us. You wanted to hear it.
Bianca, we both need a friend in this town. Okay, since we're being honest, I leveled with you, right? I mean, I admitted to you how much I enjoy sticking it to our mommy.
Yes.
Well, something about this bonding thing doesn't feel right. So now it's your turn to lay it on the line.
About what?
Tell me the truth. Are you using me, Bianca? Okay, call me skeptical, but I'm not sure I believe in the new you.
Excuse me?
Aren't you the same little obnoxious brat who poured ink all over my bridesmaid dress? And then denied it?
Oh, that.
Yeah, that. You turned my beautiful gown into a Jackson Pollock.
I was a kid.
You were the little sister from hell.
Hey, I had issues.
Hell, Bianca.
Okay, when you're right, you're right. I'm different now. Honest.
I used to hate you. I mean, I really hated you.
Oh, Kendall, that is so nice to hear.
You were so pushy, and you always acted like the whole world revolved around you.
We've established that I was obnoxious.
I was so sure you were going to turn out to be just like her.
You mean like Mom? You thought that I was going to turn out like her?
Yes. But I was wrong. You are the total un-Erica. I mean, we're talking like a complete 180.
Kendall, that's the nicest thing you've ever said to me.